Praise the living God, dear heart. Here we go again. Testimonies 03. Brother Ellis sent me another, some more audio clips of customers at the Salvation Army seeing Jesus. You know, Jesus said that he would give grace to the humble, but to the prideful person, he resists. You know, these people that appear that are customers at Salvation Army, they believe God's word through his servant, Brother Ellis. When Brother Ellis tells them, you can see Jesus. Just think, someone excited, come to you and say, you can see Jesus. You would say, and you could tell by their action and reaction, they must have seen Jesus. Okay. So they obey his simple instructions. Now he's supposed to share with me an audio of God's instructions in which God had given him for us who wants to see Jesus. Praise God, I'll be sharing that soon. But remember now, again, God gives mercy and grace to those who are humble, but if you got pride in you, then he will resist you. This is your first out of recording testimony, this young man, he said at first when Brother Ellis told him what he could do, he was skeptical about it. But then he decided to try it, which means he humbled himself. He tried it, and sure enough, Jesus appeared to him and talked with him and told him that many would not see him. They would not see him because they're not persistent enough. You have to be persistent. You have to be determined. You have to be faithful. You know, you have to give up your desires, your wants, and just seek him with all your heart. Then you'll be able to find him. That means he'll allow himself to be found. You will see him. So that's what Jesus told this young man. You know, many would not praise the living God. So I thank God for those of you who believe God's word through these people giving their testimony. Thank you for clicking like on God's testimonies. Praise the living God. And pray to that one. Pray for that one person who keep clicking dislike. That person need prayer. So pray for that person, because that person definitely needs to see Jesus. And I pray that when he see Jesus, that he will see Jesus high and lifted up on that Calvary cross, dying on his behalf, suffering on his behalf, that he literally see Jesus with his eyes on the cross. And when that happened, he will buckle down to his knees. Say, Lord, please forgive me. To pray for that person. So I'm going to go ahead and share these clips. Praise the living God. And remember, Jesus appearing to customers at the Salvation Army. Glory to his holy name.
Hello, everybody. I am here with Harvey, a customer at the Salvation Army, and he has a testimony about seeing Jesus Christ face to face. Tell us what happened when you first came to the Salvation Army, how everything first started.
Yeah, I talked to Ellis, and he explained to me that it's possible to meet Jesus face to face. In the beginning, I was skeptical, to tell you the truth, but when he gave me the procedure, I applied it when I got home around 3 a.m.
Was there a prayer or anything that happened?
Yes, there was a prayer and some meditation and prayer again, and then worship. And then finally I went to bed. And then in the middle of the night.
The same night? The first
night? Yeah, same night.
Wow.
And I felt that the room was getting cold. Mm-hmm. And when I woke up, I saw that the wall were like made of crystals, and they were shiny, and they were lighting inside those crystals. And I looked at straight in front of me, and I saw the face of Jesus. And he told me that it was going to be difficult because it takes a lot of concentration, but I definitely saw it, and I'm feel blessed.
Wow, awesome. So he told you it was going to be difficult?
Yes, because sometimes he said 3 days, some people 5 days with me. It was the first hours of the day.
So he was telling you sometimes it's difficult for other people to get this?
Yeah. It depends on the condition of that person, mm-hmm. that their level of acceptation of Jesus in their life. Mm-hmm. And then for me, it was easy. I mean, the first hours of the morning, around 3, I got into meditation, then prayer, and then meditation again, and then worship, and then it happened.
Wow, that is awesome. So, so you're going to go tell your church, spread the word, because now you're a minister. Remember I showed you the verse?
Yes.
Awesome. That is so awesome. Well, you have blessed my day, brother, and you keep this relationship going. Because guess what? The Bible says, many will prophesy in my name, but I will say, depart from me, for I never knew you.
Yes.
Well, if you're getting up at those times and spending intimate time with Jesus and the Father, they cannot say that to you.
Yes. Right.
Right?
Yep.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I'm here with little Jeremiah next door, and yesterday I decreed and prayed that he'd go to heaven and have a visitation to heaven. So Jeremiah, did you go to heaven last night in your dreams?
Yeah, and I saw the ground look just like my house. Then I saw
it was a ground.
Yeah, I saw the ground look like my house. Then I saw a castle look like that pink on my house.
Like the pink on your house? Wow.
Just like this one.
Oh, it was, what color was it?
White.
The castle was white?
Yeah.
Who lived in the castle?
The king.
The king lived in the castle?
Yeah.
Who was the king?
I don't know who's the king.
Was the king a big man?
A big man.
Was it granddaddy?
Huh?
Was it granddaddy?
A granddaddy.
Was it Jesus' granddaddy?
No, it's the king. With all in armies.
It was the king over all the armies?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, in the castle. What else did you see in heaven?
Then I see Jesus.
You saw Jesus in heaven?
Yeah.
When you went to sleep last night?
Yeah.
What? Did he say something to you?
Yeah.
What did he say to you?
He said, keep my town safe.
Keep my town safe.
Wow, that's amazing. Did you see any flowers?
Flowers? No, you know, flowers in heaven.
What else did you see in heaven?
I didn't see no more heaven.
No more heaven. Was it pretty?
Pretty.
Did it look beautiful?
Beautiful flowers.
Like, did it look nice, heaven?
Nice heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
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 Well, right on. There we go. Give me 5. Okay. Well, that's little Jeremiah with his visitation to heaven. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. She has viewpoint.
My sister-in-law called me right now. Uh-huh. She has a dream.
What?
Yes.
Wow.
She
Hold on. I want you to hear this. Okay, what she say? She had a dream.
My sister-in-law had dreams. In the dreams, she sees a Jesus.
She sees Jesus.
Yes. And she sees Jesus with many, many angels.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, she called me right now, very excited. And she had the dream in the morning, last night. She sees Jesus with many angels, and she said, never before she met Jesus face to face.
Never before.
No,
she's
never.
In Cuba, right?
In Cuba.
She's in Cuba.
And she said that Jesus said, Jesus told her, pray, but coming a difficult time.
Wow, coming difficult times.
Okay. Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Awesome.
Yes. Right now, I said, what? And I said, yes, I'm excited, but I'm worried.
And you remember yesterday when I decreed that everybody in Cuba that was doing the fast would get the face to face from Jesus?
Yes.
We did that yesterday.
Yes, and today in the morning after this. But the problem is my sister-in-law woke in the night. And she had the dream in the morning today, maybe to say at 10 o'clock.
Awesome. I was waiting to hear.
I mean, don't tell with your wife about this, but just, let me tell you, it's incredible now. And this day, wow, Ellis.
Yes, last night my wife, she got a visitation from Jesus, yes. The Father. I told you. Yes.
My sister-in-law said, never before I speak face-to-face Jesus.
My name is Moraima Lopez. I was here at the store and I was speaking to Ellis, and we prayed, well, he prayed for me. And the other day in my break in the afternoon, I was sleeping and I see his face and I feel very happy. And then he told me everything is gonna be fine. And after that day, I feel more happy and calm, and I don't feel any fear or anything.
No fear. Perfect. Yeah, love. Cast out fear.
Wow, that's amazing.
I know. I told her. I told her the other day.
What did he have? Like, did he?
I was sick and I see his face. And believe me, it was like I was happy. And then he told me everything is going to be fine. I didn't have any problem that day.
Wow.
But I was sleeping. And then I thought, okay, that's beautiful face. And then Jesus, okay. And then he told me everything is going to be fine. And then I wake up and I told him and I forget to tell you.
Wow.
Because I always have the ADHD, you know, very distracted person.
Wow, that is so amazing. And you said you were at work?
No, I was in my house, sleeping and taking a nap because I left her at the school.
Uh-huh.
And then I went to the sofa and I was okay, relaxing. And then poof, his face.
Wow.
It was very soothing and wonderful face and very calming.
Yeah.
And I feel happy. And since that day, I don't have any problem more. I'm more happy every day.
Wow.
And I told her.
That is so amazing. So thank you for listening. That's another testimony of Jesus Christ appearing. And thank you, Father, for allowing this manifestation to happen. And thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. That is so awesome. That is sweet. Remember that Jesus said, now pray, 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 because difficult times are coming. So we pray and just continue to believe. I just thank God. You know, we encourage one another. You know, when God blesses us, then we should be willing to bless others. You know, it's sad for people say they see Jesus, but at the same time, they say Jesus said not to tell anybody. Dear. Just in time, Jesus said, go tell what great things the Father has done for you. Share with others that give them hope that the same Jesus who appeared to them because they believe, he also will appear to them also. Amen. So again, thank you, Brother Ellis. We look forward for you to come on, you know, with that prayer. I asked him to do an audio. He asked to do a video, but the Holy Ghost said no. Because doing a video, he said right now, it would distract him. So it's just best to do an audio. Praise the living God. So now, dear heart, now you are to enjoy these testimonies, but at the same time, God wants you to test him. You have to do it yourself. You know, don't look for it when you go on my YouTube just to listen to these testimonies, but also to be a participator. Say, I'm going to do the same thing. You know, I'm going to do it, Lord. You did it for them. You would do it for me. All right. So seek the Lord with all your heart and just be obedient to him. And we look forward to some more good testimonies, especially what's going on in Cuba. You know, revival in Cuba. I thank God. You don't have to be well known, not to people, but well known to God. And God is appearing to those in Cuba who's not well known. Also within the United States and other areas as well. God is doing wonderful works all over the world. You better believe it, all over the world. Just because you don't hear about it on a large scale, but it's happening. You'll be surprised of how revival. People is crying out for revival, revival. You don't realize revival have already been happening for years. Why? Because God looks at the heart of a person. He's going in areas that is unknown to other people that you wouldn't even go, areas you don't even want to go to, people you don't even want to minister to. And that's where the revival is. Praise the living God. So again, dear Lord, let's be obedient to the Lord. Okay? Shalom.